going away to walk, going away to wall work, a bit of the publication from Ernest Bevin. And it explains all the things you should look out for when you're going out there. But a lot of people came to Redditch at that time, coming up from Wales and various other places. And a lot of people came to live in Redditch and stopped in Redditch. So there was a big influx of people who moved in at that time. And well, we know one or two people who came at that time. And
that's the,
well, we know their children.
HDA factory. The interesting thing about it, down here is Batchley Brook. And down there is Yule Brook, which is, so it's quite a soft area. And that's one of the reasons it was chosen, because one of the things they had was the big hammer. And they needed soft soil underneath because of the amount of pressure that put down. So it had cracked up normal land. So they were building on sort of fairly soft land. And if you lived in this area, you certainly knew where the big hammer was going, because you heard thump, 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 thump. And, you know, you really knew that was going. But again, that was 1937 they started, 1939 they were up and producing. And almost every plane in the Battle of Britain used components that were made in the HDA at Redditch.
So, just going forward here, and we were right by the VSA factory.
Yeah.
On the top, and the iron fencing would come over it.
Yeah.
But when we got home, a bomb had gone straight through the front window, straight through the back, and bedded itself in the communal garden.
Yeah. But the VSA factory in Redditch was never touched. There was an attempt, but they didn't.